students, today we will discuss respiration in plants. Now what is respiration? Respiration is the chemical process, isn't it? It happens in the cell and the food is oxidized. So the respiration reaction is C6H12O6 plus 6 molecules of oxygen, and it gives 6 CO2 plus 6 water and then energy. So this is the respiratory reaction. So overall equation for the oxidation of glucose. So respiration in fact is a complex process, and it process in which the respiratory substrate like sucrose, starch, glucose and other sugar, fats, organic acid, proteins are broken down through oxidation, and that is accompanied by the release of energy, water and carbon dioxide. Now types of respiration, that can be your aerobic respiration or anaerobic respiration. Aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Now aerobic respiration is this one, that is oxygen is required, but in anaerobic process respiration, that again two types are there, that is C6H12O6 is broken down to CO2 plus water, ethyl alcohol. So CO2 plus alcohol and energy. So this type of aerobic anaerobic respiration happens in yeast and bacteria, which is called alcoholic fermentation. So anaerobic respiration we will discuss detail later. So let's come to first about the aerobic respiration and the steps that are involved in the aerobic respiration. Now aerobic and anaerobic difference you already know, you have read in the previous classes. Aerobic respiration is very very common in higher plants, animals, but anaerobic respiration is common in yeast and bacteria, right? Even in anaerobic respiration also occurs in human muscles when there is a lack of oxygen. And in anaerobic more ATPs are formed, ATP means energy are formed, but here only two molecules of ATP, whereas one molecule of glucose gives 36 or 38 ATP molecules. So come to respiration in detail, that is first process is glycolysis. Now what is this glycolysis? Glycolysis is the first process which happens in cytoplasm, and there one molecule of glucose is broken down to two molecules of pyruvic acid. So here glucose molecule is broken down to two molecules of pyruvic acid. Two molecules of pyruvic acid. Remember, this glycolysis occurred in cytoplasm of cell. And this is very very common in aerobic as well as anaerobic. In both the organ respiration we can see this glycolysis. Now the diagram is given. You can see the diagram. So let's describe, that is in brief, like how this total process occurs in glycolysis. So glucose, first it gives to glucose 6-phosphate, then it gives to fructose 6-phosphate. Please go through the diagram which is given to you. Glucose 6-phosphate, then fructose 6-phosphate. Then fructose 6-phosphate is broken down to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. And fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is again splitted into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Now 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde is converted into 1,3-bisphosphoglyceraldehyde, and then 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid, then 3-phosphoglyceric acid, and then 2-phosphoglyceric acid, 2-phosphoenolpyruvic acid, and then to 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. So here glucose, here activator is magnesium, and wherever you can see that glucose 6-phosphate, glucose to glucose 6-phosphate means there the phosphate is added where ATP is consumed. So you will get in this process two areas, the two reaction you can say.
where ATP is consumed. And you will get again two reactions where ATP is formed. And in this reaction you will get two molecules of NADH is formed. So these are
normal, this is the net gain of ATP we can calculate from this. Otherwise the number of enzymes are needed in each and every process. Enzyme is there, hexokinase, then fructokinase, then dehydrogenase, then phosphorylase, mutase, enolase, kinase. So number of enzymes are there, so almost 10 steps are there, and ultimately you will get two molecules of pyruvic acid. So when you go to the net gain of ATP through glycolysis, then you will get like this. So here already it one NADH, so here one NADH is equivalent to 3 ATP molecules. One NADH is equivalent to 3 ATP molecules. When this NADH will undergo ETS, electron transport system, then it yields 3 ATP molecules. So net gain of ATP you will get, when you calculate it, it will get in the glycolysis 8 ATP molecules you will get. 8 ATP molecules you will get. So 4 ATP molecules are produced, 2 ATP molecules are consumed, and 1 NADH gives 3, so 2 NADH gives 6 molecules of ATP, all total 10 ATP molecules, out of that 2 ATP molecules are consumed, so net gain is 8 ATP molecules. Next one, after glycolysis, we will discuss fermentation process and where this fermentation specially occurs in anaerobic organism. And this fermentation is alcoholic fermentation, alcohol is formed, and another one is lactic acid fermentation. Now when I discuss alcoholic fermentation, that is happening in yeastern bacteria, and what is a common reaction, that is pyruvic acid is consuming NADH and then gives C2H5OH, that is ethyl alcohol. And lactic acid fermentation, where you will get lactic acid, no CO2 is formed here when the lactic acid fermentation is there. So this aerobic respiration means fermentation, and before the glycolysis happens, the glycolysis and fermentation. So these are the two processes which occurs in yeastern bacteria. And in human muscle cells, as you know, that when there is a lack of oxygen, the muscle cell undergo lactic acid fermentation for a short time period and then produce lactic acid. And as long as lactic acid is accumulated in the muscle cells, then it forms the, it creates the pain. So glucose is fermented, and here 2 ATP molecules are there. So major thing is that very less amount of energy is formed in this fermentation. So now come to mechanism of aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration, glycolysis and fermentation we have discussed in anaerobic. Now glycolysis is common, so but after glycolysis you will get Krebs cycle. This diagram is also sent to you. Go through the diagram, and then I am just describing the, it is in brief. So first, after formation of two molecules of pyruvic acid, there is stepwise breakdown of respiratory substrate normally occur. It involves that is first one, glycolytic breakdown of glucose to pyruvic acid, which you have already seen. Next is oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvic acid to acetyl coenzyme A. So the next step is your oxidative decarboxylation. Now decarboxylation means what? There is the emission of carbon dioxide. Okay. And then Krebs cycle, that is, Krebs cycle is often called as TCA cycle, tricarboxylic acid cycle. So let's come to go through the diagram. I am just describing, that is in brief. The first one is oxidative decarboxylation, that's a cycle type. So here pyruvic acid undergo oxidative decarboxylation and form acetyl coenzyme A, and here there is CO2 is released out. NAD is converted to NADH plus H plus. Okay. So both dehydrogenation and decarboxylation is occurring. And next in acetyl coenzyme A combined with oxaloacetic acid forms citric acid. And then citric acid is a 6-carbon compound. And citric acid is the first stable compound. So it is also known as Krebs cycle, is also called as citric acid cycle. And who are the scientists that are describing? Sir Hans Krebs as a scientist who discovered all these things. So let's come to now citric acid. Citric acid then converted into alpha ketoglutaric acid, and there again emission of carbon dioxide is there. NADH is formed, and now the 6C become 5C, and now alpha ketoglutaric acid is again converted to succinic acid. There again GTP is formed, CO is out, CO2 is again emitted out. So 5C become 4C, succinic acid becomes fumaric acid, then to malic acid, and there the FADH is formed, and then again malic acid, NADH is formed, and now it turns to oxaloacetic acid. So it's cycle where OAA is combining with the acetyl coenzyme A, then undergo a series of reaction, again give back OAA, that is oxaloacetic acid, and here you will get 6 molecule of CO2 is released. At the three sites there are 3 molecules of CO2 released. So if you multiply that with 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, you will get 6 molecules of carbon dioxide. And yes, here at the fourth site you will get 4 NADH plus and H plus is formed, and 1 FADH2 is formed, and 1 GTP is formed. So all these energy rich compounds are formed, 2 GTP molecules are formed, 4 NADH, obviously when you multiply with 2 pyruvic acid, then it will give you. So we will discuss net gain of ATP in detail after this Krebs cycle. So let's come to the net gain of ATP. What is the net gain of ATP? Glycolysis and Krebs cycle both together. If you say in glycolysis, there are almost, I discussed glycolysis, 10 ATP molecules are formed, but here 2 molecules of ATP are consumed, so total net gain is 80. But when you say Krebs cycle, you will get, I say 4 NADH, and when 4 into 1 NADH gives 3 ATP, and there are 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, so when you multiply it, you will get total is 24 ATP, isn't it? Then I say FADH2 is 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, so FADH2 is 2 into, and 1 FADH gives 2 ATP molecules, so equivalent to 2. So what is this? FADH2, that is 2 FADH2, 2, that is 4. 4 ATP molecules are there. So because 1 FADH2 is equivalent to 2. So here how many 2 FADH2 are formed, isn't it? Okay, you have multiplied by 2, that is molecules of pyruvic acid, and 2 ATP molecules each. So 4 FADH2, 4 ATP molecules, and the more 2 GTP molecules are there. So all total result is 24 plus 4 plus 2 is 30 ATP. So 30 plus 8. So total is 38 ATP. But that can be considered as 36 because 2 molecules of ATP are consumed when pyruvic acid moves from cytoplasm to matrix of mitochondria, because Krebs cycle occurs in matrix of mitochondria. Okay. So 36 ATP molecule is produced when 1 molecule of glucose is oxidized. Next one is, you will see the diagram of electron transport system.
That is ETS. I have
given the diagram of ETS. Just see and understand in brief. So the various components of electron transport system include cytochrome B, 2 types of cytochrome C, ubiquinone, FMN, FAD, iron sulfur protein, enzyme cytochrome oxidase, so cytochrome A and A3. So all these electron carriers are actually converted to complex 1,
complex 2, complex 3, complex 4 and complex 5. So under these four complexes, these are arranged. And these electron transport system is present in the cristae. The cristae of mitochondria, that is the inner membrane get folded, and that happens in cristae.
So cristae, and there is F complex 5, which is a cytochrome, that is a F0, F1 complex.
So complex 5 is again important, that is the F0, F1 complex, isn't it? And where ATP synthase enzyme is there. ATP synthase enzyme is there, which forms the ATP.
So ultimately, when the electrons flow from, that is through these electron carriers, that is FMN, then ferrous sulfate proteins, then ubiquinone, then cytochrome complexes, then cytochrome BC1, then CA and A3, and terminal oxidation, terminal,
that is who is accepting that electrons and protons, and that is oxygen. So when oxygen accepts all these protons and electrons, then it forms what? Water. So that is metabolic water is formed. That is the terminal oxidation.
And F0, F1 complex where ATP is formed, that is called ATPase complex or complex 5. Okay, so students, we are discussing ATPase complex that is present in the inner membrane of a mitochondria. So F0, F1 complex.
Now how it happens? You can see such type of diagram is there. This type of diagram is there, and where this is F0, F1 complex. So this one is head region, it is called as F1, and this is called F0. And then when hydrogen is passing, that is, and here ATP is formed, isn't it? ATPase complex is there, and ATP is formed. So you can see this is ADP plus one inorganic phosphate that forms ATP. Now this is the cristae. This is outer side and this is the inner side. Okay, this is matrix region. So this one, this region is called as matrix region, and this is the outside.
Now this one is oxidative phosphorylation occurs. So what is occurring over here?
This is oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative
phosphorylation is occurring. Let's come to respiratory quotient. Now respiratory quotient is what? Volume of CO2 evolved divided by volume of O2 absorbed. Now there are value of RQ, like carbohydrate it is 1, then for fats, RQ for fat is 0.7, and RQ for protein is 0.9, and RQ of organic acids we get, then it is coming under 1.33, more than 1, and in anaerobic respiration it is infinity. Okay. So more than unity you will get malic acid, that is organic acid particularly. So in this is respiratory quotient gives you the idea that where the oxygen is evolved, or oxygen is used up and carbon dioxide is evolved. So respiratory quotient is the ratio of volume of carbon dioxide released to the volume of oxygen taken in respiration in the given period of time at a standard temperature and pressure. Now what is amphibolic pathway? An amphibolic pathway, that is entire respiration is considered as catabolism or a catabolic pathway, and breakdown of certain respiratory substrate provides carbon skeleton for the synthesis of large number of essential plant products, isn't it? So it is an anabolic pathway also, the same respiratory process which acts as a catabolic as well as anabolic for the synthesis of various intermediary metabolic products and secondary metabolites. So it is an amphibolic pathway. So entire respiration process is an amphibolic pathway because it involves catabolism as well as anabolism. So please go through the diagram. It's a number of long questions are involved, like glycolysis, fermentation, Krebs cycle and ETS. So these are the four questions, long questions that you will normally get. And respiratory quotient is a short question. Amphibolic pathway is a short question. And number of differences are there, like respiration and combustion differences. And what is oxidative phosphorylation and what is photophosphorylation, which are very, very important. Photophosphorylation is seen in photosynthesis, isn't it? But here oxidative phosphorylation. In presence of oxygen, there is synthesis of ATP. So go through the diagram and read NCERT thoroughly and join the offline class. Thank you.